during this period, did you have an interest for shipping? Because I feel there's some generational effects here that my generation isn't that much into shipping, but maybe you're in the age where it was natural at 18 years old to read the shipping analytics and stuff.
No, I don't think I was drawn to shipping at the age of 18, and really I started working in finance with a firm that was focused on shipping and energy. But it is a fascinating industry because it's on many levels, really. I mean, the world needs shipping to go around. If you take a more of a macro view, 95% of all goods in the world travel at the ship at some point. So it's really it's part of the engine that makes the world go round. And it's also an industry with some fantastic opportunities to make good returns if you get it right. I mean, I think everyone knows the success of ship owners who've made it right, and maybe you hear less about the ones that got it wrong. But there's no doubt that it's an industry with great opportunities. And then I think it's one of the few industries still that has strong level of personal relationships and contacts. You know, very large and dominant companies are controlled by, and I'm not talking about us, I'm talking about the really big shipping companies. They're controlled by individuals who are hands-on, you know, dealing with the business day to day. And it's this combination of globally important industry that can have large swings, which can make people good returns if you get it right, and strong individuals, very different individuals with a hands-on approach to running the business.
Definitely. If we talk about the macro for just one more second, I think, am I biased for saying that Norway has a good position in the shipping industry, or is it just because we have some few Norwegian people that done extremely well? Or do you have countries like Portugal, etc., that should be positioned to be good in shipping that isn't good? Because which country has the best competence in shipping from
I
the
mean, it
company's side?
depends, of course, which part, but I think Norway has had a very strong heritage in shipping, and it probably dates back to the age of whaling, if you were to find the beginning, maybe even the Viking era, if I think about it. But today, I think Norway has is definitely a global hub for shipping, which makes it possible to establish and run shipping companies out of Norway. And you have everyone that goes into the ecosystem. There are good capabilities. There are good shipping lawyers. There are good financiers, both on the debt and equity side. There are good ship brokers, and there is good talent for building shipping companies. So it's in a way fascinating that you can start a company in Norway, you can work with the best advisors, and you can attract some of the best people globally to run that company.
How much it's oil related in terms of the shipping competence in Norway, or is it not paired at all? If you have the oil competence, is it natural synergies into shipping, or is it not?
I guess there are probably some synergies, but there are dominant companies in crude shipping in Norway. You have, of course, Fredriksen, controlled by John, Frontline, controlled by John Fredriksen. You have DHT, which has a strong presence. You have Norwegian American Tankers with a strong presence. So some of the most foremost companies are in some way affiliated with Norway.
So is it correct to say that the success of the big ones are individually driven and it's not really Norway? We're just lucky to have some people that have extremely big talents in shipping, and then we have the ripple effects into Norway as a whole with competence and hubs, etc.
I think behind the most successful companies, and I mentioned some of the good ones that have come out of Norway, there are strong individuals that have been good at managing risk, and I think you have to attribute a lot of that success to those individuals. But it's impossible to run any kind of company with one person alone. It requires a team of good people, And I think the good people that enable these businesses to be run out of Norway are hugely important.